Hi, this is Harish Bali from Technofair. Through this video, we will learn about how to use Google Drive in Gmail. Apart from that, you will get a fairly good working knowledge of document collaboration, editing and saving the edited document. For those of you who are new to Google Drive, may visit and see my previous video on how to use Google Drive. So here we go. The first thing that we do is, let's open drive.google.com. You can log in through your Gmail username and password. Go to the create button and let me for this exercise make a new folder by the name practice work. So I create a new folder. Oh, it's already there. So let me delete the old folder. So here we are. I have already have a document by the name demo doc on my desktop, which I drag and put it on the folder. It's asking for certain permissions that it will convert the file to a Google Doc. That's not a problem. So I say start upload. So it's starting the upload. And once this completes 100%, my folder is here and my file is below the folder here. Let me show you the document. This is a practice work to demonstrate document collaboration. That's cool. So what I'm now going to do is I go and open my Gmail inbox. Since what I'm going to demonstrate is document collaboration after sending the document through Google Drive. So I am going to send this document to my friend Johnny through an email. I say, hello, can you edit this document needed for online collaboration? That's cool. So I click on plus button, insert the document. It's asking for options whether I want to upload the document from my computer or from my drive. Since I already have this document on my drive, I choose the my drive option. Go to the folder where my document is already there. I check this box and I say insert. After this, I can see that my document has got inserted in my compose message. I click on send. Once I send it, it is asking me whether I want to share this particular document with anyone with the link or only with the recipient of this email. I choose this option and I want to give editing rights to Johnny. So I choose the edit option. Then I click on share and send. Once I send this particular document, Johnny receives it instantly. Meanwhile, let's open the document. We will need to wait for Johnny to revert and do the online collaboration so that we can watch whatever he's trying to do. Once I see this sign, it means that Johnny is already there. He has seen the document. Let's see what is he trying to do. Plus, this is a link to his Google Plus profile. I think he is trying to do something. Oh, he has bolded the document and also put it in italics. What is he writing? Done. Oh, that's cool. Seems he has also put a comment. Oh, check it. So I reply back through a comment. Thanks, Johnny. So all this action that Johnny has performed, we could see it live on our screen. Similarly, if I now write, thanks, Johnny, for quick action. So Johnny could see this live as well. So I now go and let's say change the font color to red. So it's red. So I don't need to perform a control S like we do on Microsoft Word doc. There are certain actions that I can perform after this editing and online collaboration has been done. First thing that I can do is, let's say I close this file. And whenever I go to my document, it will be as per the last saved. So it saves automatically. Thanks, Johnny, was my last comment and it is there. So if I, let's say, write check 123 and it is automatically saving. I close the file. The moment I open it, I will see check 123 as being there. Then there are certain other actions that can be performed. Like I can go to file, make a copy of the file. I can put this file on a particular folder. Then I can even send this as an attachment on an email. then I can, within the email, I can change the format to various options like rich text format or maybe plain text or Microsoft Word. I can type the email ID to which I want to send this email, which can be a non-Gmail email as well, and then I can send it. Then there are certain other things that I can do as action for this particular document is I can click right on the document, go to the share option, and from share option, I can choose to share this link on my social media. That's either on Google Plus or Facebook or Twitter. Let's say if I want to share this link on Facebook, I will click on Facebook. This is the option recommended for Facebook. Anyone with the link can access this. Then I click on Share to Facebook. I will need to enter my username and password and then log in. It will take me to the Facebook and share that link on my wall. Then there is, you may want to change the editing right to a view right to Johnny. For example, currently the rights that you have given to Johnny are he can edit the document. Since you are the owner, you may want that he should be given can view rights. So you change the rights to can view and then save the settings. For some reason, if you want to take back the rights from Johnny, you don't even want that he should see the document also. So what you need to do is you need to go back and click on crosshair. That's first action that you need to perform, save changes. Second action that you would need to perform is you can go back to this setting and from anyone with the link, you move this to specific people and then save it. So what happens is Johnny was one single person with whom I shared the document. Now I have taken back the document. So who can access? So it's privately accessed and only me, I have the right to this particular document. So I say done. So once I am through with this, Johnny does not have a file at his Google Drive. I have taken it back and removed it from his access. Through this tutorial, I have explained how to use Google Drive in Gmail to send documents, do online collaboration. I also demonstrated online chat option and finally various actions that I could perform after the editing was done. Hope this has been useful learning, and if you have liked it, click on the comment box and do share your inputs on how useful this has been. And also subscribe to the channel by clicking on the subscribe link for more technology related stuff. Also visit our website www.technofair.com for various blogs on technology. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks.